What's up, Lego fans? Sorry there hasn't been a new review in a while. I've been a little busy with schoolwork, health problems, well, my own personal health problems. And I recently got two Inferno figures, but I'm just here to do another Lego review. But before I begin, for those of you who have watched my Hero of the Rails Talking Hero review, thank you so much for making it my most popular video on the channel, because I now have over 100,000 viewers on it. I'll make it more clear in another review. But the main reason I'm bringing you this review is because of this guy. Hero Factory Breakout Jawblade. This is one of the villains in the Breakout series. We have actually four in the series. We have Black Phantom, Toxic Reaper, Jawblade, and Splitface. The first wave. Get this out of the way. But then in the first wave, the second wave consists of XT4, Speeda Demon, Core Hunter, and Voltix. I'm looking forward to some of those. So, Jawblade is a shark, which is kind of cool, and he's got a few parts that I'm actually interested in. Comes with 200 game points. I've already mentioned they don't work. So, we all chose his gimmick with the moving jaw. Looks pretty good. So, why don't we open up Jawblade and see what he actually has. Okay, I'm just gonna carefully cut this open. Oh, and just so you know, this is one of the smaller sets. The smaller sets are, for the first wave, are Jawblade, Toxic Reaper, Evo, and Surge. Alright. I think you got that out of the way. Get this out of the way. Take care of that. Alright. Here we have some instructions. Just gotta get rid of this. Excuse me while I raise my camera. Alright. Instructions. Okay, instructions. Go up to page 26. Smaller build, already mentioned. There. Okay, here's what we got. For parts, let me just sort things out and see what we have. Black hands, we already got those. Well, let me see here. Socket joiners. I think. There's a red piece here, which is used for the tail. Oh! Here's another one. Forgot about these ones. But the red Technic connectors are a new color for me. Okay. Here's a new piece for me. This piece. This was used on Bulk 3.0. Came with two of these. And these were released in white for the Green Lantern set. What else? Technic bushings. Most of them are, there's a few Technic pins in here. Most of them are Technics. I've used them before. Put them outside. Let's see else. More of these. Missed a couple of these. Oh. Well, here's a new one. This is a Technic pin with a stopper. This is going to be used for the tail. Well, well, what do we have here? It's a ball game. A little ball. It has a cut through the middle. Used on the tail. Alright. What else have we got here? Spikes. Red spikes. These will be used. So. Mm-hmm. Oh, this one. What else? Oh. I believe we got three of these. Two of them. This one is good. But these two are going to use arms, but I'm going to replace them with these ones instead. They're much more useful that way. And here's a new color for me. These shortest ones. Red and red. For me. Perfect for me. Ah, a double one. Remember this piece from the Broadjaw set, which was my first review? Yeah, pretty good. Alright. A translucent one. This will be used on Jawblade's head. Huh, no new piece. This was used on the Black Phantom set with the legs. And I think a Rock XL, too. Alright. Huh, here's one I haven't seen in a while. First time I saw these was with Ferno 1.0. And we also saw these with the Black, with the Fire Lord set. Great. Okay, with the body, it's the standard one. Normally, I wouldn't be happy, but because of the gimmick they use, I can accept that. It's pretty good. Sorry about that. Anyway, I normally wouldn't like this in the set, but because of the jaw gimmick that a Jawblade uses, I'll accept that. Also, I have these. I actually saw these first on the Ferno 3.0 set. Looks great. On to the new parts now. Except the Hero Core. I tried the codes already. It don't work. Okay, as for the new parts we have here. First up. Silver pieces in 3 and 5 longs. There's actually 4 longs with Bulk 3.0. I might get a couple of 2 of those. Next, we have a translucent orange piece in a 6 long. Pretty good, huh? Then we have this. This is going to be part of his jaw, and it's silver. These were actually first released with the Mystica sets. Can't remember which one it was used. Another Mystica piece. Wing pieces. These are going to be great for using. Two are going to be used for the tail and two are going to be used behind here. Finally, the head. It looks appropriately sharky. And it looks great. Don't at the jaw, it doesn't look complete. Now, okay. Now that I've shown you the parts, parts here. Here, just gonna carefully move them out. Nope. So, what do you say we put this guy together and see what he's got?
Shaking cold, these hands are meant to hold.
Think you'll be.
And all you gotta keep is strong. Move along like I know you do. And even when your hope is gone, move along just to make it through. When all you gotta keep is strong, move along like I know you do. And even when your hope is gone, move along just to make it through.
So here we have Jawblade all completed and ready to go. Now, before anyone asks where my Evo and Toxic Reba combination went, is, well, I took it apart because it was about time I took it apart. Plus, it wouldn't take room on my display shelf. But the character design is actually pretty good. I used these joints right here instead of the ones that came with it. Came with three of these ones. And one thing that does bug me a little bit is the jets for feet. It looks good, but if you're fighting underwater, it would have been good if you had some regular feet. But I understand that some people mean, you know, that Lego Jang doesn't like the design of it, but I think it looks very sharky, and appropriately sharky. Now, also to note that the blades from Inferno 1.0 are called magma blades. I like how some of the pieces are good. The silver in particular looks great. The silver, the red, and silver, red, and black looks great. The head looks very sharky. You can move this up and down. But the main gimmick here is the jaw. You pull this down, the jaw back, and the fins move forward. Looks like he's about to take a bite out of a hero. Ouch! I wouldn't tangle with this guy. The figure itself looks great. I am sure that Jawblade may be one of the smaller characters in the first wave, but he's definitely good. And before anyone asks, I am not going to make the Inferno Jawblade combination. It looks terrible. Even in the instructions, it looked bad. So no, I'm not doing that one. But As for if you do want a sharky character, and if you're a big shark fan and like sharks, Jawblade is definitely the one to get. But if you're in the mood for some new parts, and some of the old Mystica hard to find ones, I get them too. Well, this has been one pretty interesting review. But I'll get some more heroes eventually. So until then, this is Mr. Duck and Bubbles, signing off.